Maryland Attorney General Doug Gansler is defending himself after comments he directed at Lieutenant Governor Anthony Brown, who is running for governor. The comments were recorded secretly during a meeting attended by Gansler, who will announce next month that he's running too. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live in the newsroom. He has the very latest for us. George?
Well, Rod, the Brown campaign says Gansler's comments imply Anthony Brown is banking on his race to help him become the next governor. The Brown campaign wants an apology, but tonight, Gansler was unapologetic.
Maryland Attorney General Doug Gansler on the defensive after what he calls a private campaign volunteer meeting last month was secretly recorded by someone. Gansler is heard making a comparison between his gubernatorial campaign and Anthony Brown's.
Right now, his campaign slogan is, vote for me, I want to be the first African-American governor of Maryland, which is fine. And look, there's no one bigger on diversity than I am.
Tonight, Gansler did not back down from his comments, which he said were taken out of context by the Washington Post, which first obtained the recording and reported the story.
You can look at the transcript. I said absolutely nothing wrong. In fact, I said what I think people believe, that we shouldn't be talking about race in this campaign. We should be talking about whose ideas, whose vision, who has leadership, and who has character to be governor of Maryland.
Either way, the Brown campaign capitalized on the comment.
For us, the best thing to happen would be for the Attorney General to apologize and we can move forward. The only person using race as a divisive issue in this campaign so far is the Attorney General.
No, the Washington Post reporter brought that. What we said was exactly what is in the transcript, which is we shouldn't talk about race.
On the tape, Gansler specifies race when discussing his lieutenant governor pick.
It'll be an African American, and it'll be somebody from either Baltimore or Prince George. I cannot overstate the amount of pressure I have with both of those places to get a person from there.
We live in a state with the number two minority achievement gap in K-12. That's got to be addressed. Hopefully that'll be addressed by a lieutenant governor or myself, and so we need to have people that reflect the community that we're going to be representing.
Gansler says he has no plans for an apology. He then attacked the Brown campaign for dirty tricks. He suspects someone affiliated with Brown infiltrated the meeting and gave the recording to the Post.
If Anthony Brown wanted to know what we were doing in our campaign, he could just pick up the phone and call me. You know, they don't need to commit a felony to do it.
Now, Gansler says whoever recorded the meeting broke Maryland's wiretap law, but he says he will not press charges. Meanwhile, the Brown campaign denies planting anyone in the meeting to record it. In the newsroom, George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.